And today I'm going to talk about the forced homelands from Turkey. Most of them are not well known, so you are going to be shocked after my presentation. So as you know, Turkey is situated in a very important place between three major continents like Europe, Asia, and Africa. So it won't be wrong to assume that Turkey has a really important potential for early homeland migrations. But unfortunately, Pluristesen works is very limited in Turkey, and the most of studies are comes from 40s to 70 years old, and based generally in the southern part of Turkey. Of course, it doesn't mean that the early humans populated or migrated this part, but it means that the studies focused on this area. But in last years, some scientists start to work in this area, and we hope that they found some new fossils from the area, and I'm going to also plan to conduct a new study, Pleistocene study, and I hope that I can find the fossils before the other scientists. So here you can see seven Pleistocene sites. Of course, there are a lot of settlements, but these seven are just the Gil fossil human remains, not stone artifacts or stone tools, but just the fossils. So I will start with the older one, and of course, my favorite one, the Kocabaş in Denizli province. It gives a Homo erectus, the oldest fossil hominin from Turkey. It was found in Tavertan blocks by a geologist, Professor Dr. Cem Alçık in 2002. And early dating attempts was not so good, but in recent, there are some good dating attempts were conducted in the area, and it yields that the fossil is at least 1.2 million years old, and three other groups, one from US-Turkish team and one French-Turkish team, and the third one is myself and my colleague from Greece, suggest that these fossils belong to Homo erectus. And there are also some other fauna remains were found in the area, like Equus, Rhino, Mammoths, and other one. They also found some stone tools, artifacts, but I don't know what they are. We shall wait and see what happens. And the recent publication showed that Homo erectus lived in a lake environment in before 1.2 million years ago. And here's some pictures. These are my hands, so you can use a scale. This, we have a right frontal bone with supraorbital torus and right periodontal, and left periodontal with frontal without supraorbital torus. So we made mirroring in the studies and made all complete supraorbital torus to study. This area was cut during the factory workshop in Tavertan blocks, so we don't have, unfortunately. And the first publication, it is assumed that these fossils has a tuberculosis, a pathological remains, but it is a little bit hard to say that because some other scientists say that it is just a post-mortem modification and it's not a tuberculosis. But I heard that some paleopathologist is going to work and make a new study about that, so let's wait and see if it is tuberculosis or not. So the second one is currently the best excavated area cave in Turkey. There are about 10 meters sediments in the cave, so you can see very clearly the sediments in this cave. It's situated in Antalya. I hope that I know that most of you know it. It's about 30 kilometers from Antalya and 450 meters far from sea level. So the oldest sediments is about 400,000 years, and a hand axe was found there. I heard someone from the excavation that they found a tooth in the area, but we have to wait for the publication to know which hominin has this tooth. And the other parts, 350 and 2,000 years, gives a lot of human fossils, you can see here. In the first publication, they assumed that they belong to archaic Homo sapiens, but a recent publication, a French scientist assumed that this belong to Homo neanderthalensis, according to work on femur. So the other part, 250,000 to 200,000 years, there are some phalanx, radius, fibula, mandible, and they assume that these remains also belong to Homo neanderthalensis. And the younger part, as you can see here, the days, 160 and 60,000 years, there are also some teeth and some teeth from adults and youngs. They also belong to Homo neanderthalensis according to who conducted the study. So we know that Homo neanderthalensis populated and habitated the cave for a long time in this cave. And here you can see the pictures of cave. So this is the femur, which was published very recently and show that this belonged to Homo neanderthalensis. So now I really like to say that I don't have a lot of pictures from now on, because the most of publications are very old and they don't have any pictures, or they are very bad situation, so I don't want to put them. And some publications have not been published yet, so I don't have pictures. Forgive me about that. So I will just talk to you about them. The other place is a rock shelter is near from Karin, again in the Antalya province. Some cranial fragments and right and left femur found in 59 and 60s, and Professor Bostanji assumed that they also belong to Homo sapiens, modern humans, and the date is between Upper Pleistocene and the end of Upper Pleistocene and maybe beginning of Holocene. Unfortunately, the documentation is not good, so we don't have very exact date for this case. Here you can see the rock shelter and the more close one. So, after Antalya, we go to the Hatay. This area is Hatay and very near of the Syrian border. There are a lot of caves. The first one is Merdiveni Cave. It's about 40 meters from sea level, and in 56, some human remains like molar tree, bone fragments, lytics, found on remains like cave bear, cave lion, and wild boar, which used the cave at that period. And the date of these remains is middle and upper Pleistocene, and other some remains from middle Pleistocene level were also found, like two permanent upper molar and a permanent lower molar. And the Shengrek and Bostanji, our professors, assume that they also show some Neanderthal characteristics, but there's no clear conclusion in this publication, unfortunately. And I tried to find these bones to make a maybe near study, but unfortunately, no one knows where they are. So it's pictures of the cave, as you can see here. And the other cave is Kanal Cave, is very near the Merdiveni Cave, just 600 meters far from the other cave, Merdiveni Cave. And there is also some teeth remains and also one canine. And Professor Bostanji assumed that it belonged to Homo neanderthalensis. And the other molar show some modern characters, and he named this with a subspecies. This is the area's name, Chevrik, Homo sapiens chevrikiensis. And they dated to the upper Pleistocene age. Here are the pictures of the cave. And the last cave in this area is Injili Cave. It's just about 300 from the Kanal Cave and 6 meters from sea level. A mandible, maxilla, femur, tibia, vertebra, and foot bones were also found in 73. And Bostanji also said that these are very similar with the other cave, and he also named as Homo sapiens chevrikiensis. But unfortunately, we don't have again dates, but Bostanji assumed that they should be along the upper Pleistocene level in that moment. Here, the last pictures of the Injili Cave. And this is the last cave, and it's still being excavated by some professors from University of Ankara. We have very good dates for this cave, fortunately. It's from 41 to 17 thousand years before present, and it's just 20 meters far from sea level. The excavation between 1809 to 2012 gave some teeth, 14 isolated teeth, a fragment of maxilla and cranial fragments, and the date of these remains is between like 30 to 40 thousand years old. It's just a poster presentation, so I don't have pictures about that, sorry. And the 10th of these isolated teeth were studied, and they say that they should belong to Homo sapiens, modern humans, but they also show some Homo neanderthalensis characters, but they don't have a clear conclusion about that. So they said that the work is underway and going to be published soon, but it didn't publish yet, so we have to wait again to see what happens, if it is Homo sapiens or Homo neanderthalensis. The cave was used as a kitchen, so there are a lot of faunal remains, and these humans eat one-eighth like aurochs, red deer, pig, fallow deer, and other herbivore animals, and consumed it in a very large amounts. They also found stone tools, bone tools, and very, very unique shell ornaments in the cave. It is here the sea, and where before I took this picture, there are some other caves inside it, but unfortunately they didn't publish the study, so we don't know the exact conclusions about the caves. Here you can see some references which I used for my publication, for my study. So we know that at least three different human species, Homo erectus, Homo neanderthalensis, and modern Homo sapiens lived in Pleistocene and area in Turkey. So we have to make more work to find out new fossils in Turkey, because we have a really, really good potential for that. Thank you very much.